In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Good morning, brothers and sisters. We offer this sacrifice of the Mass for the eternal rest of Mary Arvin. Today we celebrate the Divine Mercy of God. Today is the Divine Mercy Sunday. Today the Church wants us to recall the love that He has for sinners and to thank that love for us. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie.
Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast Kindle the faith of your people you have made your own. Increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, and by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of its possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles. And they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his mercy endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. I was hard-pressed and was failing, but the Lord helped me. My strength and my courage is the joyful shout of victory in the tents of the just. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. Give thanks to the Lord, for good. His love is everlasting.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were, for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now, a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord. Can we give a definition to the mercy of God? What is God's mercy? Today is the Divine Mercy Sunday, and we should reflect on the mercy of God and what are its implications in our daily lives. We can say that God's mercy is the fervent and ardent love he has for sinners to save them. We constantly hear and we see everywhere, Jesus loves you, but we do not really understand this statement. It is like an advertisement, but it says nothing to you. What does it really mean that we see, that we say, God is mercy? And it is this, that God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten Son to save us from our sins. He has a great, ardent, zealous love for sinners. And he wants to save them. He wants to set them free from their sins. He wants to give them new life here on earth and eternal life after this life. This is the real meaning of God's mercy. When we say Jesus loves you, we are not saying, do whatever you want, you will go to heaven anyway. You don't have to change your life. You don't have to convert or repent from your sins. This is what we are not saying. But instead, we're saying, you sinner, I sinner, we sinners have hope. We have hope. We can have a new life. Our sins can be forgiven. We can have peace. We can be delivered from the slaveries of our sins. This is hope for the sinner. What do we have to do in order to receive Christ's mercy, especially today that the church wants us to recall the mercy that God has for us, a mercy that endures forever? We have to receive the Holy Spirit. We have to receive the Holy Spirit. Notice what Jesus says in today's gospel. Receive the Holy Spirit, whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained. Let's meditate a little bit more about this. And I'm going to read for you some words from the Catechism of the Catholic Church. Some might say, Father, why are you constantly quoting the Catechism of the Catholic Church? Well, because we no longer know what our great grandparents knew, and we have to be re-evangelized. The Catechism says, conversion requires convincing of sin. For us to receive the mercy of Christ, we have to convert to him. It includes the interior judgment of conscience, and this being a proof of the action of the Spirit of truth in man's inmost being. The Holy Spirit, who dwells in us, brings to light all the dirt we have. And because of our blindness, we're not able to see. The Holy Spirit brings to light our wounds, our sins, for them to be cured, for them to be healed. He is our heavenly physician that singles out where is our wound, where is our sin, and how can heal it so we may live. We have to let the Holy Spirit come upon us so we can see better, know ourselves better. The Lord says, receive the Holy Spirit. Becomes at the same time to start the start of a new grant of grace and love. Receive the Holy Spirit. Thus, in this convincing concerning sin, we discover a double gift. We discover a double gift. As we are aware that we are sinners, that we need to be healed and forgiven, we discover a double gift. The problem is that we no longer know what is sin and what is not sin. We have informed our conscience well, and we are confused and blind. This is the question. This is the main question. That sin no longer exists. Everybody is nice. Everybody is good. But for us to receive the mercy, the saving mercy of Christ, we have to declare ourselves before the Lord, I am a sinner. I need to be healed. I need to convert to you. And St. John says in one of his letters, he says, whoever declares himself to have no sin is a liar, and the truth is not within him. Is a liar, but whoever confesses his sins, Christ Jesus justifies him and gives him new life. So as we declare ourselves as sinners, according to the Catechism of the Catholic Church, we discover a double gift. The gift of the truth of conscience, light to see. And the gift of the certainty of redemption. As soon as you confess yourself to be a sinner, someone needing forgiveness and healing, as soon as you acknowledge that, you start to experience hope because there is redemption and salvation for you. So the message today that we, the church, should address to everybody is, you sinner have hope. Your sins can be forgiven, you can be healed, and you can have life. Approach the merciful and risen and glorious Christ. Approach his sacred wounds. Touch the nail marks that are the everlasting proof of Christ's mercy for the sinner. This is the message. It is not, you're fine. It's okay. We constantly hear this. It's okay. It's okay. You're nice. It's okay. It's okay. No, you have to change of life. Because the love of God is a changing, is a healing love that changes you, that transforms you. It makes you a new creation. This is the love of Christ. Now, the other thing that we see in today's gospel is that Jesus constitutes his church as a vehicle of his mercy and forgiveness. He has given authority to his disciples and apostles to forgive sins in his name. St. Paul says in his second letter to the Corinthians, he says, verses 18 to 21, chapter 5, he says, and all this is from God, who has reconciled us to himself through Christ and given us the ministry of reconciliation. The church has the ministry of reconciliation. Namely, God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting to us the message of reconciliation. We are bearers of the message of reconciliation. So we are ambassadors of Christ. So we represent Christ. We, ministers of Christ, represent him, make him present among his people, and bear the message of reconciliation, the grace of the forgiveness of our sins. We priests, every man who has been ordained, has been given the authority to forgive sins in the name of Christ. We're ambassadors, that is to say, we represent Christ. And he finished, and he ends saying, for our sake, So we are ambassadors for Christ, as if God were appealing through us. As if God were appealing through us. We implore you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. Be reconciled to God through us, who are the ministers of the message of reconciliation, who forgive sins in the name of Jesus Christ. For our sake, he made him to be sin, so who did not know sin, so that we might become the righteousness of God in him. What did Jesus say to his disciples and the 12? Receive the Holy Spirit, whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained. I bet you have heard many times from many people, I will not kneel before someone who is a sinner just as I am a sinner. Poor person. That's the only thing I can say. And pray for that person. Poor person, because you're missing to receive the forgiveness of your sins. Christ himself have given them the authority to forgive sins in his name. Poor you. Poor you. Your pride is not allowing you to see, and you are rejecting God's mercy. Poor you. You have stiffened your knees so that you cannot kneel before God, before the ambassadors of Christ. You have stiffened your knees because of your pride, and you are rejecting God's mercy. We priests are the first ones to acknowledge that we're sinners. We know, but we do not act on our own. It is Christ who acts in us. But we have to have the eyes of faith in order to see this and to understand this. It's a matter of faith. And whoever does not believe this is because that person lacks of faith and of humility, of course. Today is a day to say, thank you, Jesus Christ, for your mercy. I am a sinner. I have hope because of your mercy. The gates of heaven are open for me because I can receive from you the forgiveness of my sins. Thank you, Lord. And thank you for your church, who is the bearer of the grace of reconciliation, especially through the ministry of your priests, in whom you act, in whom you are made present out of mercy for us. Today we have here exposed this picture of the divine mercy, those rays coming out of Christ's side, symbolizing the water and the blood that flowed from Christ's heart when he was hanging on the cross. What does that mean? What does that mean? It means that God was showing his mercy even when Christ was dead on the cross. When the soldier pierces his side, he's already dead. And that water and blood means that I am loving you even when I am dead. That's what he's telling us. God's mercy is even manifested in Christ's death. He didn't stop loving us while he was dead. They mean the sacraments of baptism, water, and the sacrament of the Eucharist, the blood. It is by these sacraments that we are saved and reconciled by God. Remember what Jesus commanded us many things, but mainly two things. Two things, mainly two things. And he commanded this expressly. Baptize in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Preach repentance and forgiveness of sins. Preach conversion. This is how we spread the mercy of God, by preaching conversion and repentance. This is how people experience in their life the saving power of his love. And remember what he said. Do this in memory of me. Take this. This is my body. Take this. This is my blood. This is how we are saved, brothers and sisters. Let us understand this. And let us be thankful, especially today, that the Lord has promised to Sor Faustina Kowalska that he would pour out many graces and blessings, especially on this day, the second Sunday of Easter. Let us pray in silence. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in the mercy of our Lord, we present our supplications for the Church, the world, and for one another.
We pray for the whole Church, recalling today the gift of forgiveness that Jesus gave on that first Easter with the breath of his Holy Spirit, that all may come to his fountain of mercy. We pray to the Lord. That like the first flowers of Jesus, the rich may bring their surplus to be distributed according to the needs of those who have nothing. We pray to the Lord. For all who question and doubt the reality of the risen Christ, and who, like Thomas, let their stubbornness, that Jesus may invite them into his wounds and restore their faith. We pray to the Lord. For the newly baptized and for us all, begotten of God and filled with the faith that conquers the world, that the power of faith may show itself in our obedient love, we pray to the Lord. And for all those who are in season of suffering, for the loved ones we carry in our hearts, that the joyful power of this Easter may become strength, light, and healing in their lives. We pray to the Lord. For our faithful departed ones, that Jesus, who came through water and the blood of his loving sacrifice on their behalf, may bring them rejoicing into heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Let us pray for the eternal rest of Mary Arve. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray especially for the conversion of sinners, and also that Christ may pour upon this country and its civil leaders his mercy, his grace, so that they may repent and convert their hearts to him and hear his voice. Let us pray to the Lord. God of heaven and earth, listen graciously to the prayers that we humbly present to you, trusting in your divine mercy. In the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord.
As our gifts are prepared at the altar, please join in singing number 530, Peace. so that your joy be ever full.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
The Savior's command, and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Bring your hand and feel the place of the nails, and do not be unbelieving, but believing. Alleluia.
Our hymn during communion is "Eye Has Not Seen," number 462.
Teach us the wisdom.
those who see with eyes of faith, the Lord is ever near, reflected in the faces of all the poor and lowly of the world. Eye has not seen, ear has not heard what God has ready for those who love Him. Sing a mystery from the past in halls where saints have trod, yet ever new the music rings to Jesus' living song of God. Again, we pray in song, singing Roll Away the Stone, number 177.
Stone. They have been saved.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads or kneel for the blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing. May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance. And may you who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. Regina Celi, letare. Alleluia. Quia quem meruisti portare, alleluia, resurrexit, sicum dixit, alleluia, ora pro nobis Deo.